Whereas to circle the line of the expression where the student made a mistake evaluating the expression, then we're asked to evaluate the original expression correctly. So we simplify expressions using the order of operations, which are outlined here for review. Following the order of operations, step one is to simplify within the innermost parentheses or grouping symbols. Step two, simplify all expressions with exponents. Step three, multiply and divide from left to right. And step four, add and subtract from left to right. So looking at the original expression here, we want to simplify within the innermost parentheses or grouping symbols, which means the first step here should be to find this difference here. And notice 4 minus 1 is 3, so there's no mistake in this line. Now for the next step, we simplify inside these grouping symbols or brackets, and notice how we have multiplication here and addition here. Following the order of operations, we multiply and divide from left to right before we add or subtract. So the next step should be to find the product of 5 and 3, which would give us 15. Just notice not what the student did. The student actually performed this division here, but the 12 is inside the brackets and the division is outside the brackets, so this was the mistake. So here is where the mistake was made. There's a mistake in this line here because the student should have found the product of 5 and 3, not the quotient of 12 and 3. So now let's go back to the original expression and evaluate this correctly. We already know the first step is to simplify inside the innermost parentheses here, which gives us 3. So we have 16 plus the quantity 5 times 3 plus 12 divided by 3. We still want to simplify inside the brackets, and notice how we have multiplication here and addition here. Looking at the order of operations, we multiply before we add. So the next step, we want to find the product of 5 and 3, which is 15. So we have 16 plus the quantity 15 plus 12 in brackets divided by 3. We're still simplifying inside the brackets. So the next step is to find this sum. 15 plus 12 is equal to 27. So now we have 16 plus 27 divided by 3. We have two operations left. We have addition and we have division. And notice how we divide before we add. So the next step is to perform this division. 27 divided by 3 is equal to 9. So we have 16 plus 9, which equals 25. So 25 is the correct value of the given expression, not the 37. Let's look at another example. Same type of problem with a different expression. So we first want to identify the mistake the student made. So following the order of operations, we simplify, again, inside the innermost parentheses or grouping symbols, which would be here. 5 minus 2 is 3, so this line is correct. Now we want to simplify inside the brackets, and we have addition here and multiplication here. Following the order of operations, we multiply before we add, so the next step should be to find the product of 3 and 12, which notice is not what the student did. The student found the sum of 6 and 3 to get 9, which is incorrect. So there's a mistake in this line here. Let's start over and do it correctly. So we already know the first step is to simplify inside the innermost parentheses, which in here would be the difference here of 5 minus 2. Which is 3. So the next step is 21 plus the quantity 6 plus 3 times 12 and then divided by 2. Still simplifying inside the grouping symbols or brackets, we now know that we multiply before we add. So the next step is to find the product of 3 and 12, which is 36. So we have 21 plus the quantity 6 plus 36 and then divided by 2. Still simplifying inside the brackets, we now find the sum. 6 plus 36 is equal to 42. So we have 21 plus 42 divided by 2. Now we have addition and division left, and we know we divide before we add. So the next step is to find this quotient here. 42 divided by 2 is equal to 21. So now we have 21 plus 21, which equals 42. So the correct value of the given expression is 42, not the value the student found of 72. I hope you found this helpful.